Students, now we have some questions related to the story that we had done. You see, what did Lencho move for? Lencho moved for a downpour or at least a shower. Why did Lencho say the raindrops were like new coins? Lencho was comparing the raindrops to new coins because his field was in need of what? Rain. And now, after this rain, he will have good harvest, and after selling it, he will earn more and more money. How did the rain changed? The rain changed into? Did his use, that's why the rain changed into hailstone. What happened to Lencho's field? Hailstone destroyed Lencho's field completely. Nothing was left, not a single leaf was left. What were Lencho's feeling when the hail stopped? He just told to his son that even the plague of locusts leave more. He was telling that all work had gone in vain. And this year we will go hungry. This year we will go hungry. This is what he told, he expressed. Now children, the next, you see, the next paragraph. But in the hearts of all, he has lost his hope at that moment when he found his field destroyed completely. But then again, you see what happened. But in the hearts of all, who live in that solitary, and single, lonely. Solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope held from God. But suddenly, one ray of hope that came in his mind. And what was that in his heart that was held from God? Now he decided, if everything is settled, everything is vanished, when you found only darkness is there, who is there to help us? Almighty is there always. That's why he had that hope. That Almighty is there and He will certainly help me. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember no one dies of hunger. Now he is consoling himself. He is telling, we should not get upset. When we find everything is lost, when we find everything is destroyed, at that moment also we will have to remember that nobody is going to die because of lack of food. He is telling that there is a ray of hope in him. Ray of hope that is help from Almighty. That's what they say. No one dies of hunger. So, now see what happened, children. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope. What was his hope? Help from God. The help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, see everything. So, it was in his mind, others have also told to him that God can see everything because he is present everywhere, he is omnipresent, I have already told. Omnipresent. He is present everywhere. We can't see him, but he is present everywhere. So, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. What do you mean by conscience? The word and inner sense of right or wrong. That is our heart. That is our heart that is guiding us. Antaratma ki awaaz jo hamari hoti hai, antaratma jo hoti hai, our inner self that is knowing what is right or what is wrong, that is the sound of our heart. So here the writer is telling, and Lencho is about Lencho only. So Lencho has faith in God. He is telling, he is thinking, that is there in his mind, that when nobody is there, God is there. He is omnipresent. He knows everything. Even he knows what what is going on inside of our heart, what is going in our heart, what we feel. This is what God is knowing. That's why I told God is knowing everything. He decided to share this problem to God. Let you was an ox of a man. What do you mean by ox of a man? Ox of a man means he was very much hard working. Ox of a man means man means very much hard working. He was very much hard working. Lecho was very much hard working. So here you see, like an animal working in the field, but still he knew how to write. So he was knowing how to write the following Sunday, coming Sunday at daybreak. Daybreak is what? Beginning of the day. That is beginning of the day. Daybreak means beginning of the day. Again, I repeat, daybreak means beginning of the day, early in the morning. So he began to write a letter, which he himself would carry to town and place in the mail. So now he decided that he will write a letter. He will go to post office and he will send it to Almighty. It was nothing less than a letter before. So he decided to write a letter. Now see what happened, what he has written. God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. So he was narrating his problem. He was telling his problem to Almighty, that God, we need your help, otherwise we will go hungry for the whole year. I need 100 pesos in order to shop my field again and to leave until the crop comes because the hail stopped. So he discussed everything here. He has told, what do you mean by peso? Sorry? Peso, it means a standard unit of currency that is used in Latin America and Argentina and parts of the world. So he told, you see here, that I need 100 pesos because I need to sow my field, means beech field se dalna hai field mein, and then I have to survive and my family has to survive. We don't have anything, please help us, because hellstorm has destroyed everything. He wrote to God on that day. And what was the address he has written? He had written to God, because nobody is knowing what is the address of the God. And see how much innocence he was. That is written to God on the envelope at the place of, on the envelope at the place of what? Address. Put the letter inside and still troubled went to town. And now he went to town. At the post office he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. Now he has posted it. What happened, you see? One of the employees who was a postman and also helped at the post office went to his boss laughing heartily. He was laughing at his fool. But Jor se haste hue and showed him the letter to God. Because when he received an envelope on which the address, what was the address to God was written, he started laughing because it was a strange thing that he found. It was completely the new thing that he found. He was not thinking that anybody can write the letter. That was not in the mind of him, that anybody can write letter to God. And the address was also written, of course. You can imagine the situation. Showed him the letter to God. Never in his career as a postman had he known the address, the postmaster of fact. Amiable. What do you mean by amiable?
It means very friendly and pleasant. Friendly and pleasant. So, the postman went to the postmaster with that letter on which the address to God was written, and he had shown that the postmaster, a fat, a very pleasant, a man of cheerful mind, also broke out laughing. He also started laughing. What happened? The person has written a letter to God. What is the reason? But almost immediately, he turned serious. But just after a few seconds, he became serious. Why? He just wanted to know the reason. What is the reason behind it that the person started writing letter to God? So that's why, tapping the letter on the desk. So he tapped the letter on the desk and commented, "What faith?" Yes, of course, he became serious. What type of faith he has that he has written a letter to God? Maybe he was waiting for his reply also. What type of faith that person has, of course. I wish I had the faith of the person who wrote this letter, and he was wishing the same, having the same faith as the farmer had, starting up a correspondence with God. So what sort of faith he had that he started communicating with God, he started writing letter to God. Now see, so in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea. Now one idea came in his mind. What was that idea? I narrated you this story. I hope you remember it, children. You see, answered the letter. Now he decided that he will answer the letter so that the person who has great faith in God, he will be happy. He will feel that God has replied me. That faith will remain there in his heart. That's why. But when he opened it, it was evident. Evident means clear, very clear. It was clear that to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. So when he read the letter, he found that he was demanding 100 pesos. Jab usne letter ko padha to woh paya ki it was not possible to write a letter with ink, with pen only, or with some good wishes or some words of good wishes. He was in need of money. It means I will have to help him with money. But he stuck to his resolution. Resolution means what? That is war. Usne shapath li thi. Oath bhi hota hai. So, now what happened, you see, he was very much firm, he was very much determined that he will answer to this letter. He was determined that he will write this, answer this letter. So that's why he asked for money from his employees. Now he decided to collect money. He himself gave part of his salary. And now he gave some part of his salary, and several from the friends of his were obliged. They were also feeling that they are doing some great work of charity, to give something for an act of charity. Charity means not to help somebody, a work of kindness, to give somebody daan karna. It was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos. Gather means, what do you mean by gather? Children, gather means what? To collect. So here, he was unable to collect. Yeah? You see, he was unable to collect that sum of money. But finally, but he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half, that was 70 pesos. Little more than half, 50, थोड़ा ज्यादा उसने कलेक्ट कर लिया. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lin Chu and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature. Signature of whom? That was the signature of God. So finally he had written the letter, and with that address nothing was there, only what was written in the letter? God. And who received that letter? Lin Chu. In the next class we will discuss some questions. After that we will complete the chapter. Thank you, students.